In this video, Amnesty International takes a look at Myanmar ahead of its first elections for 20 years. We talk to former prisoners of conscience who are still fighting the authorities despite the incredible risks they face.
I always try to forgive those who beat us, who tortured us, because one day we need to cooperate.
We find out what the elections mean to communities in the midst of conflict in some of the most dangerous parts of the country. Even a quick glance at Myanmar's recent history shows a complicated story of political struggle, repression, and human suffering. Aung San Suu Kyi is still under house arrest after the National League for Democracy, the party she led, won a resounding victory at the last elections, but was denied the opportunity to take office. Now Myanmar prepares for its first elections in two decades, and as news agencies start to cover the election campaigning as part of what the government calls a roadmap to democracy, we'd like to find out if the human rights situation has changed. Our destination, Mae Sot, which lies on the river dividing Myanmar and Thailand. It's a major trading post and a melting pot of refugees, migrants, smugglers, and aid workers. Many fighting Myanmar's repressive rule have fled to the Thai border town, including Bo Chi, a former political prisoner and human rights activist. Over the last 22 years, he's demonstrated unfaltering courage, sharing his story and those of other political prisoners, and exposing the military government's human rights violations. Even in Thailand, dissidents aren't safe from the reach of the Myanmar intelligence, who have denounced Bo Chi as an enemy of the state.
I believe in myself, therefore I could survive here. Maybe, who can say? Everyone will die sooner or later. Therefore, what I have is my commitment to democracy and human rights, that's all. That is my defense, not others. I do not have any weapons, any guns, or anything.
Many of my friends, they died in prison because of torture, because of starvation, and then some people are suffering from mental illness and mental problems. So because like the prison trying to rob your dignity, and prison trying to kill you, your, at least like your intellectual killing.
There are more than 2,000 political prisoners in Myanmar's jails. Students, doctors, mothers, artists, everyday people who sacrificed everything by peacefully standing up to the military government. They now find themselves serving up to 65-year sentences in awful conditions and at daily risk of torture. Zaganar, a popular political comedian, remembers his time behind bars.
When I start to sleep, they pour the water to me and they ask me to stand, and they beat and they kick, and sometimes they use a rubber pipe to beat my back and my belly. I passed 5 years lonely. I only heard the voice and sound of the man or woman or birds or any sounds. I cannot see anybody. They don't like me because I am the stimulator, I am the agitator, and I am the organizer, so they don't like me. Our country's people, our Burmese people, they don't dare to criticize, they don't dare to speak aloud. So I am their loudspeaker.
You're not allowed to talk to a foreign media like me, yes?
Yes,
you're banned from talking to me.
Yeah. I think that is their opinion. That is their side. But at my side, I I can talk everybody. I can freely interview with any foreigner or any foreign radio or any foreign TV station. This is my right. I must stand for my rights.
Zaganar was rearrested and is now serving a 35-year sentence for collecting money and supplies for the survivors of Cyclone Nargis.
The government of Myanmar really wants to portray these elections as part of a roadmap to democracy, but in fact, going all the way back to the 2008 constitution and the government's behavior, there's been a real attempt to shut down the three crucial freedoms that are necessary for a meaningful election: freedom of expression, freedom of assembly, and freedom of association.
Maysot is not only a refuge for political dissidents from the mainstream political opposition fighting for their rights, but also for people from ethnic minorities fleeing conflict in the east between armed groups and government forces. 3 days' journey by river from Maysot takes you into Keren State, eastern Myanmar, where many people have been displaced by conflict, and fighting still continues. Access to information is a big problem here. Most people don't even have access to radios, the only source of information other than state propaganda.
The run-up to the elections, we've seen the government really cracking down on critical voices, on opposition voices, and as a result, the government of Myanmar has effectively robbed its people of the opportunity to have a meaningful election.
A repressive veil of censorship hangs over the country, giving the military power to dictate the election process.
There's a lot of attention right now on Aung San Suu Kyi, the Nobel Peace Prize winner, who has been in detention for most of the last 20 years. She's been under house arrest. But there are still more than 2,000 people who are imprisoned for simply voicing their opinion. Only pressure from Myanmar's neighbors will focus the attention of the government and create the opportunity for an improvement in the human rights situation in the country.